Right, now at the entrance to the Pine Woods, there's two tracks you can see, one that goes through there and the main one over the other side. They go to the same place. There's a circle basically that you start here, walk all the way around and then come back down that path to there. But then there's this path here, which is not one that I have trodden. I think it might link up with that one over there, but I'm going to go check it out before going through the Pine Woods and coming out at the Harlow Carr Gardens. So let's evaluate a few things. I walked down that path, the third path into the Pine Woods, and came out into part of the expanse where I discovered there was a third path that actually runs parallel to the other two, all the way through the Pine Woods, up to this point here, which is halfway to Harlow Carr. And at this point, the path joined route to Harlow Carr, but I discovered this one going down in that direction, and also one that I hadn't seen going up, which I haven't followed yet. So both of these run sort of through the pine forest, but in a sort of perpendicular, that's the word, cross. So you get to a crossroads. And I've only followed the horizontal beam ever before, so now I'm following the vertical beam going down from the pine forests into this sort of little this sort of yonder valley, really. So I'm going to see where this leads. And then I shall head back up, and I might try going out above the pine forest. So basically straight through in that direction, rather than coming from that direction, and going that way, which is where I sort of wanted to go to explore the ringways path, which is right out there. So, sorry, it's a bit confusing. I'm also a little bit strange because I tend to name places and routes that I find along sort of journeys like this. Obviously, they will have their council given name, but I was quite intrigued when I once read in the Old Testament that when they discovered a new place, they would name it. They would sort of build a little pillar and name it in honour of whatever took place at that place, and that word, you know, if it was a meeting place, for example, they met somebody, they would put up a pillar of meeting, and eventually the name would be called meeting or whatever, as a sort of geographical name. So I tend to do that on my journeys, and then not know when I read on a map or something like that exactly where I am, because I the place names in my head that I've of course made up are all different from the place names on the map. But there we are.